Swaminathan Aiyar, who has seen many an elections and knows really the pulse of the nation. Swami, morning. Great to have you on the show. Swami, as you know, Indians begin to cast their votes today. If you were to sort of do a SWOT analysis for both NDA as well as UPA, who do you think seems to have an upper edge?
Without doubt, I would say the NDA. I would say they have 70% chance of winning at this point of time.
So why do you think BJP will sweep the elections this year too, and what are their key strengths? Let's begin with the S first.
The strengths of the NDA first is Modi. He's by far the most popular leader in the country. He's more popular than his own party. Important, he's held in high regard by youngsters who are forming an increasing part of the electorate in every election. So this is positive. Nationalist credentials, after Balakot, after the surgical strikes, after Uri, this party is able to boast, you know, I am the person who's able to take on Pakistan. Look at these wimps in the Congress. They did nothing after the various earlier blasts or the attack on Parliament, but we are willing to take action. So, you know, their nationalist credentials at this point, they are emphasizing, and it's strong. The BJP has by far the election war chest. If you look at that, I think it has 95% of the electoral bonds. It's the incumbent, so it has plenty of money. It has strong and growing cadre strength, which is important to bring out the voters in a thing like this. A relatively uncorrupt image. It is seen to be serious about issues like sanitation, rural cooking gas, electricity to every house. It can lay claim to serious reforms like bringing in GST and the insolvency and bankruptcy code. And one thing which most people miss is inflation is down under 4%. Historically, this is an important indicator of success. High inflation is deadly. Low inflation can be good for the incumbent. So these briefly, I would say, are the strengths of the UPA. The strengths of the NDA. What about the UPA? I think the main strength from their point of view is anti-incumbency. Elections are often lost by incumbents rather than won by the opposition. And anti-incumbency is strong. It has been very, very apparent in the last number of state elections that the BJP does badly if it is incumbent and does better if it is anti-incumbent. So there is an anti-incumbent trend, and that is the strength of the UPA. It has won these three elections in central India, Rajasthan, Chhattisgarh and Madhya Pradesh. So it has some momentum going for it, plus some new sources of campaign financial we had. It will be the largest single bloc if the BJP is defeated. So it's in a better position to form a government than a hung parliament. I think the Nyay program which they have come out with, this giving 72,000 per family to the bottom 20%. There's a lot of cynicism among people on whether it will be implemented, but it's become an important talking point. So it is giving them something, and there's a certain amount of intellectual credit which is got to them on that account. And finally, you can say a strong point is that historically it's got a significant proportion of the votes of Muslims, Christians, Dalits. This, however, has been eroding and is less of a strength than it used to be. So on balance, if you look at those two comparisons of strengths, I think definitely the NDA has the upper hand.
Okay, so you're fairly categorical about the NDA's strengths. But you spoke of the UPA government, Swami. You spoke about Modi. What about Rahul Gandhi? How do you think he has evolved as a politician from 2014 to now?
If you have to ask about weaknesses, I would say a weakness of the Congress party is Rahul Gandhi. If you compare with many of the previous Indira Gandhi, Jawaharlal Nehru, even Rajiv Gandhi, even Sonia Gandhi, I would say that there were better speakers, more inspiring leaders. He's getting a little better. He's not as bad as he used to be. But I would say he is definitely a handicap and not a strength. The exact opposite of Modi, who is a very good speaker. He can connect well with audiences. He can get feedback from them. To that extent, he's in some sense a natural-born leader who has forced his way to the top, whereas Rahul Gandhi has merely inherited the mantle and is not looking particularly well qualified to fill those shoes.